Hey guys, good morning or good afternoon, wherever you are. So today I wanted to take a picture of M101, which is Pinwheel Galaxy. Pinwheel Galaxy is in Ursa Major constellation. Pinwheel Galaxy is one of the best spiral galaxies that we can see. If the picture is taken very well and if the resolution is good, you should be able to see the arms of the spiral galaxy very well. Actually, very nicely they named it as like 101 of the galaxies. They didn't name that way, but it sounds that way when you look at M101, the Messier 101 and the Pinwheel Galaxy. One of the things I was thinking was, how do I improve the picture quality and get a better picture of the Pinwheel Galaxy? So if you saw my previous videos, I was talking about, I was doing the 2x2 binning. 2x2 binning actually is going to improve my image scale. I talked about that in the previous video. And what it is also, the side effect of it is my 4000x4000 picture becomes in half. It becomes like 2000x2000. So as if I used, rather than a 16 megapixel camera, I use like 8 megapixel camera. I'm just making it easier to understand, but your image is cut in half, right? So, but if you have, let's say, a 16 megapixel camera, and if you can take a picture of a 32 megapixel camera, like, you know, rather than a 4000x4000, if you can take a 8000x8000 picture, that improves the quality of the picture. The improving the quality of the picture, you can do it many ways. Like when you say define quality, right? How do you define a good picture, right? So what we call as a good picture for astrophotography is you have a better signal to noise ratio, SNR. You have a better signal to noise ratio for your pictures. So if you take smaller exposures, and if you take whole bunch of them, and if you stack them, your signal to noise ratio improves because you have more signal, less noise. That's what it is. So the other way to do it is actually to take darks, right? But really speaking, most people, what they do is a process called dither. So what this dither process does is, whenever the picture is taken, like by frame after frame, so for every frame your telescopes move slightly. So when you stack them, it knows because which one is the signal and which one is the noise, because you're kind of moving few pixels here and there the frame, so it kind of understands this is signal versus this is noise because of the dither process. I'm more interested not in the dither only, I'm more interested in improving the quality of the picture. There is a concept called drizzle, right? If you drizzle the picture, you are actually doubling the size of the image so that your image quality improves. But the problem of drizzle is, you won't be able to drizzle an image if you haven't done the dithering. So that's why I ended up doing the dithering of the image, so that I can drizzle my image. It was a little bit difficult for me to understand in the beginning, but anyway, so if I stack my pictures by doing a dither, which is like slight movement frame by frame, during my stacking process, I could drizzle my picture so that my quality of the picture improves. I'll show you guys that workflow, how simple actually these two things are. They sound complicated, but how simple they are. I was thinking these two are really complicated, but I figured out it's not that complicated. They're actually pretty simple process, but really going to help you taking a better quality picture. Let me show you guys my workflow of how I took the M101 Pinwheel Galaxy.
So here is how it will get done. So I'm going to show you guys the files that I need to bring in from the last night. So I'm in that folder. So I'm trying to take the approved files. I used a process called subframe selector to identify the files that I wanted to include. So now I'm taking those files into a process called image calibration. You have my settings here, and here is my master bias file, my dark file, and then here are my settings, and that's pretty much it. And there's a bunch of files. This process will take some time, but this is how I calibrate first. Once the image calibration is done, we can go into the drizzling. Let me pause here for a second. All right, image calibration is done. So if you wanted to save this process for future reference, you can set an icon identifier saying that IMG calibration lights V2 or something like that, and then save your process icons. So that way, when you bring it back up, you can easily utilize the same format or the same settings that you have here. That will help you not redo this, all the settings again. Okay, so now the next step that I wanted to do is, I can remove this one. I don't need that anymore. Of course, I have to resave my process icons, and I'm good to go. All right. So the next step that I have to do is the debayer. So far we haven't got into the drizzling yet. It is the step after the debayer. So I took the LRGB using the monochrome filters. So right now I wanted to combine them. So after calibration, I'm trying to put these files into, so here is my V2, and I need all these files, and I wanted them to go to, under V2, I create a new directory, a new folder called for the debayer, right? And then I run this process. So let me pause here for a second. All right, the debayer process is done. And now we are going to do the next step, where we actually start the first step inside the drizzle files. So if you go to the star alignment process, you can see my settings here. There is one checkbox here called generate drizzle data. So this is the file that I wanted to use for my reference image, right? One of my images is my reference image, and these files I would be selecting it from my debayer directory now. And once I select, I wanted them to go to a new directory here called sa-drizzle. I select that folder. And that's pretty much it. So your star alignment, you can see the settings here, will create not only the star aligned files, but they will also create the .drz, the drizzle data that you need. And let me start the process. Yeah, this will take a few more minutes. Okay, star alignment is done. Here is the next step that you have to perform to actually create the drizzle data. So go to image integration, add all the files that you need from the star aligned files. They will all have that underscore R for the files. This will generate the necessary drizzle data that you need. So star aligned creates the first set of drizzle data, and then the image integration creates the other set of drizzle data. When you perform this task, you get two things. You get an image that is the original resolution of your file, and also in the same directory, it is going to create the necessary Drizzle data files that you need. So let's execute that. I'll pause it for a moment. That image integration, it must have created the files in the folder. Here is the integrated image. Here is the integrated image. And then if you see the resolution of it, it is, this is M101, the pinwheel galaxy. So you can see it's actually roughly like 2000 by 2000 kind of an image. What we are looking for is to have to double this resolution, right? You can save it, this file, like file save as. I already did that. And go to Drizzle integration. So as part of this Drizzle integration, what you can do is you need to go to the star alignment directory where it has written those files, the xdrz files. So select them all. And actually I wanted to also integrate another set of data from this date. So together they will do what we call the Drizzle integration. If it is color, I think you need to enable the CFA images. I have not tried this part yet. I still use the monochrome images. So this is just the luminance part of it. All right, so this is the image before I drizzled the image. So the Drizzle integration gave me this image now. Let's look up this one. So this is the luminance image of M101. So if you can see the resolution of this image, the resolution of this image is 2000, as you can see, 2000 by 2000. That's the size of the image. Whereas if you ask for the resolution of this image, let me make it the same setting. Okay. So if you ask for this image, this is actually a 4000 by 4000 image. So, I mean, I don't know if you can see visually any difference between these two, but if you can, like, you know, zoom into one of the quarters of this image, if you can zoom into one of the corners of this image, you might see slight variation at the same level. Or even if you wanted to go closer, you can see slight improvement in terms of signal on this one. And that does matter a lot. This is actually a half the size of this one. So obviously at the same level that your eyes can see more photons on the right hand side, a better resolution on this side. So you have to perform this Drizzle integration workflow that I just showed you, these are the ones. Like you perform your these steps here, the image calibration, the debayer, the star alignment, image integration, and then you have to perform the final step, which is the Drizzle integration, in order to get this image that you need.